It is better to conquer yourself than to win a thousand battles. Then the victory is yours and cannot be taken from you. Not by angels or by demons.
You are...
Okay to me.
Well, you don't expect
the last time you did.
Hey!
We all have different problems, okay? We all have different ways of handling them. You know, look at Millie. She's got to rub her hands raw with that hand sanitizer.
Would you like some hand sanitizer?
No, I'm okay, Millie.
Dude, I can use more than a little sanitizing. Does anyone know how long we're supposed to be stuck here? Because I don't think I'll have enough hand sanitizer for more than a couple of hours. Maybe less if I share.
No, Millie, you don't have to share it before I'm low. We'll make sure you have enough.
Thanks, Eli. I don't mean to be selfish, I'll share. I just need to know how long we're going to be here so that I can accurately ration.
Millie, it's okay. I understand.
I just don't like germs. I don't like to be touched.
Neither do I.
I'm not much of a fan either.
I'm not a big fan of germs being touched or hand sanitizer, but that doesn't really seem to be the point right now.
Weird. It's like limo or something, you know? Or somewhere that's nowhere.
Hey guys, we need to think really hard about the last place we were before we got here. Just think for me, okay?
For every evil under the sun, there is a remedy. Or there is none. If there is one, seek till you find it. If there is none, never mind it.
Who is it?
Eli!
I was in my locker.
Getting your pocket protector? I remember that it was after school.
I said I was in my locker, not at my locker.
In your locker?
That's not funny!
Yeah,
and knock it off!
Arnold, it might be embarrassing, but we have to know the last thing you remember.
You guys in the football team held me upside down and threw me in my locker. It's dark and I couldn't breathe.
Is that it?
I'm claustrophobic. I was crying.
Shut up!
Well, you're a tough girl now, aren't you? Not quite so tough when the boyfriend is slapping you around.
Hey, what? Off!
Oh, you're gonna be the knight in shining armor, Eli.
Right now, you just need to shut up and sit down.
You gonna make me?
If I have to.
Stop it! There! Hey.
Listen to your sister, Cyrus. You're not helping. What about you, Tabitha? Where were you?
I was in the gym.
Is that it?
That's all.
Are you sure?
It was just an accident. I was at chemotherapy. You didn't think this was a fashion statement, did you?
Yeah, that's what I was doing too. A little chemotherapy.
I hardly call what you were doing therapy.
A little visit with Dr. Feelgood always does the trick. Right, little LSV chocolate?
I don't think so.
Right, I forgot. A little brownie goes in, but...
Not helping!
Hey! Just because I was in the bathroom doesn't mean I was vomiting.
I was in the bathroom too. Not the same bathroom, and I wasn't vomiting. I was washing my hands. 10 times.
I was packing up for a week with my mom. Or maybe my dad.
What about you?
I was writing a note.
A note? To who?
I don't know. To everyone.
What was it about?
I don't know. What about you, Eli? What were you doing?
We're not
Eli.
Talking about me.
Well, maybe we should.
Eli!
Where are we?
Huh?
Eli!
Wait, I'm not remember! Okay? I just want to figure out what got us here.
Why?
So I can get us out.
Maybe some of us don't want to get out, huh?
Why would anyone want to stay trapped here?
Eli! Because it's safe.
You'd rather stay safe and trapped than fight your way out to freedom?
Someday, yes. And today is someday.
I was in my room. There's this little glass doll I had sitting on my dresser. It was perfect and beautiful. It had a least, I thought he was a friend. But he wasn't! While he was there, Gusto fell to the floor and broke. I picked her back up and glued her together the best I could. She still had some cracks and bruises, but I still see some dreams behind her eyes. Logically, I know the time was 10 when Sabi was getting sick. Getting into the car accident or suddenly losing my vision. But how do I know it won't help? The one time I don't do it could be coincidental that I needed to do it. And that could be a catastrophe. Germs are bad and dirty and can cause illness, disease, and pink eye, which can cause blindness. And even if I don't catch something because I don't wash my hands, I could pass on illness, disease, and pink eye. And I don't think I can live with myself if I cause somebody else to go blind. I have to wash my hands. 10 times. Always 10 times.
Acute myeloid leukemia. That's what the doctor said. I was young, but I knew when he said acute, he wasn't talking about my sweater. It sucked before I knew I had cancer. I was tired all the time and I couldn't breathe. But after I got the diagnosis, it sucked even more. Now not only was I tired and out of breath, I got that vomiting and hair loss to the list. I remember when I was 15, and I couldn't wait to get my driver's license. 6 months seemed like forever. Now 6 months seems like a blink.
I know I'm not perfect. I know I can never be perfect. When you look around, imperfections everywhere. And I'm not fat. I know I'm not fat. I'm just big bone. But you don't see big bone girls selling you jeans.
Heck, big bone girls don't even sell you cat food.
What's a big bone girl to do? A big bone girl who likes her food. She learns to adapt. She really chews food.
And pizza's not a friend the second time around. I don't enjoy going into the bathroom after every meal. I'm turning on the water so that nobody will hear me. I'm staring into the toilet, trying to psych myself up, like I'm responsible for the winning basket of the championship game. Kneeling on the cold, hard floor. Why are bathroom floors always so cold? I hate the way that it sounds, and the way that it smells, and the way that it makes me feel. It's not easy.
Neither being a big bone girl in the skinny girl world. He loves me. I know it. He really does love me, and I love him. He needs me, and I don't know what I would do without him. When we first started going out, he was so sweet. He would call me every night, and he'd talk until 3 o'clock in the morning. He would hold my hand down the hallway, but he'd never let me go to lunch without him. But lately, he's been a little stressed out. He's been yelling a lot, and well, sometimes he forgets I'm not as strong as his buddy, and he hits me a little too hard in the arm. Today we had a pretty big argument, and it was my fault. I mean, I really shouldn't be texting any other guy. Yes, we have a few ups and downs, but he loves me. He just has a funny way of showing it.
I just wonder why. Why me? Did I wear a sign the first day of school that said, "Hi," or "Punching Bag"?
I didn't do anything to anyone. I just want to go about my own business. I want to get to my classes without being hit, tripped, or sent for a swirl. I want to get my books without being shoved into a locker. I want to get from my locker to the bus without having foul language shouting at me. And for what? I'd like to ride the bus without having food and garbage pelted at me. And not being set on fire. Be nice too.
Pie. Sweet, sweet pie. Beautiful, tempting, and deadly. She's what drives me. The only thing that drives me, motivates me, pushes me. That next high, that next escape. Nothing else matters. Not life, not death. Just her. I will do whatever it takes to spend just one more second wrapped in her arms. Lie, cheat, steal, whatever it takes. She tried to kill me once. A few more seconds with her would have turned me into a vegetable. She left me lying in my own vomit on the ground, convulsing. But still, I can't break her hold on me. I tried to stay away. Really, I did. But she calls to me. All day, all night, begging with me, pleading with me to come back. And I always do. Why stay away? It's so much easier to be with her than it is to be me.
So, Mom comes home after a girl's night out. The bad boy sparks on that bougie the boomer. And hi, Mom. She comes home around 3 a.m. and decides we need to have a talk. I have an 800-point chemistry test in the morning, and you want to talk? So she sits me down and says, things aren't really working out between me and your father. Really? It's been 18 years, and you're just now deciding things aren't working? My parents are constantly reminding me that the choices I make affect my future. Well, what about you? How are your choices affecting me? Are you going to be the one shuffling from house to house every other weekend? And where do I spend Thanksgiving? Or Christmas? Or my birthday? Who gets me on my birthday? And when you find happiness by getting married and having kids with some other unsuspecting victim, what happens to me? Will you even remember me? You still have time in me?
Everything dies. I learned this when I was
went fishing by myself for the first time by the river, and I caught this little sunfish. It was way too small to keep, and I really wasn't planning on catching or keeping anything. I was so excited. I brought my dad's favorite fishing lure, without asking. I was 8 at the time. I didn't know what I was doing. I just wanted to be like Dad and to go fishing. So I caught this fish, and I started to take the hook out like I had done with Dad a million times before. And it wasn't coming out. The stupid thing had swallowed it down past its gills. I tried, but it just wasn't coming out. I had a knife. A small, dull little pocket knife that I carried around everywhere I went. I cut the line and I tried again, but it just wasn't working. All I could think about was how mad my dad was going to be when I told him his favorite fishing lure was in the bottom of the river. I knew what I had to do. Held the fish down, and I started to slowly cut its head off. It squirmed and wriggled and did everything to save its own life, but I kept cutting it. I had to. Everyone dies, but not everyone dies in front of you.
Eli, let go! There's this little black doll I have sitting on my dresser. How can kids substitute?
Acute myeloid leukemia!
Here's the thing. I know I'm not perfect. I know I can never do it. Everyone just loves me.
I just want to know why. Why am I, sweetheart?
The mom has come after a girl and I have this friend. She's willing to have
everyone die.
Grace?
Yes?
you. God, I'm so sorry.
For what?
For killing you.
Killing me? No, Eli, you didn't kill me.
Yes, I did. I should have stayed away from the river that day. I know, I would have stayed home like I was supposed to. I could have.
Eli, would have, should have.
I shouldn't have gone in for a swim. I shouldn't have let go of you. Never have let go.
You were 8, Eli. A child. I was your older sister, and I was there to protect you.
But you died to save me.
Yes, Eli, I did.
Why did you have to die?
Eli, you need to let go. Just let go of the guilt and the pain. Everyone has their own demons to face. This is your battle, Eli. You have a chance to fight.
Just a little girl. That's not fair.
No one ever said that life would be fair, Eli.